Penguin Audiobooks presents The Age of Spiritual Machines by Ray Kurzweil. Read by Alan Sklar.
The gambler had not expected to be here, but on reflection, he thought he had shown some kindness in his time. And this place was even more beautiful and satisfying than he had imagined. Everywhere there were magnificent crystal chandeliers, the finest handmade carpets, the most sumptuous foods, and yes, the most beautiful women, who seemed intrigued with their new heaven mate. He tried his hand at roulette, and amazingly, his number came up time after time. He tried the gaming tables, and his luck was nothing short of remarkable. He won game after game. Indeed, his winnings were causing quite a stir, attracting much excitement from the attentive staff and from the beautiful women. This continued day after day, week after week, with the gambler winning every game, accumulating bigger and bigger earnings. Everything was going his way. He just kept on winning, and week after week, month after month, the gambler's streak of success remained unbreakable. After a while, this started to get tedious. The gambler was getting restless. The winning was starting to lose its meaning. Yet nothing changed. He just kept on winning every game, until one day, the now anguished gambler turned to the angel, who seemed to be in charge, and said that he couldn't take it anymore. Heaven was not for him, after all. He had figured he was destined for the other place, nonetheless, and indeed, that is where he wanted to be. "But this is the other place," came the reply. That is my recollection of an episode of The Twilight Zone that I saw as a young child. I don't recall the title, but I would call it "Be Careful What You Wish For." As this engaging series was wont to do, it illustrated one of the paradoxes of human nature. We like to solve problems, but we don't want them all solved, not too quickly anyway. We are more attached to the problems than to the solutions. But in the 21st century, things will be different. The human species, along with the computational technology it created, will be able to solve age-old problems of need, if not desire, and will be in a position to change the nature of mortality in a post-biological future. Do we have the psychological capacity for all the good things that await us? Probably not. That, however, might change as well. Before the next century is over, human beings will no longer be the most intelligent or capable type of entity on the planet. Actually, let me take that back. The truth of that last statement depends on how we define human. And here we see one profound difference between these two centuries. The primary political and philosophical issue of the next century will be the definition of who we are. But I'm getting ahead of myself. This last century has seen enormous technological change and the social upheavals that go along with it, which few pundits circa 1899 foresaw. The pace of change is accelerating and has been since the inception of invention. As I will discuss in a moment, this acceleration is an inherent feature of technology. The result will be far greater transformations in the first two decades of the 21st century than we saw in the entire 20th century. However, to appreciate the inexorable logic of where the 21st century will bring us, we have to go back and start with the present. Computers today exceed human intelligence in a broad variety of intelligent yet narrow domains, such as playing chess, diagnosing certain medical conditions, buying and selling stocks, and guiding cruise missiles. Yet human intelligence overall remains far more supple and flexible. Computers are still unable to describe the objects on a crowded kitchen table, write a summary of a movie, tie a pair of shoelaces, tell the difference between a cat and a dog, recognize humor, or perform other subtle tasks in which their human creators excel. One reason for this disparity in capabilities is that our most advanced computers are still simpler than the human brain, currently about a million times simpler. But this disparity will not remain the case as we go through the early part of the next century. Computers doubled in speed every 3 years at the beginning of the 20th century, every 2 years in the 1950s and 1960s, and are now doubling in speed every 12 months. This trend will continue, with computers achieving the memory capacity and computing speed of the human brain by around the year 2020. There is a plethora of credible scenarios for achieving human-level intelligence in a machine. We will be able to evolve and train a system combining massively parallel neural nets with other paradigms to understand language and model knowledge, including the ability to read and understand written documents. Although the ability of today's computers to extract and learn knowledge from natural language documents is quite limited, their abilities in this domain are improving rapidly. Computers will be able to read on their own, understanding and modeling what they have read by the second decade of the 21st century. We can then have our computers read all of the world's literature, books, magazines, scientific journals, and other available material. Ultimately, the machines will gather knowledge on their own by venturing into the physical world, drawing from the full spectrum of media and information services, and sharing knowledge with each other, which machines can do far more easily than their human creators. Once a computer achieves a human level of intelligence, it will necessarily roar past it. Since their inception, computers have significantly exceeded human mental dexterity in their ability to remember and process information. A computer can remember billions or even trillions of facts perfectly, while we are hard-pressed to remember a handful of phone numbers. A computer can quickly search a database with billions of records in fractions of a second. Computers can readily share their knowledge bases. The combination of human-level intelligence in a machine with a computer's inherent superiority in the speed, accuracy, and sharing ability of its memory will be formidable. Mammalian neurons are marvelous creations, but we wouldn't build them the same way. Much of their complexity is devoted to supporting their own life processes, not to their information handling abilities. Furthermore, neurons are extremely slow. Electronic circuits are at least a million times faster. Once a computer achieves a human level of ability in understanding abstract concepts, recognizing patterns, and other attributes of human intelligence, it will be able to apply this ability to a knowledge base of all human-acquired and machine-acquired knowledge. In the second decade of the next century, it will become increasingly difficult to draw any clear distinction between the capabilities of human and machine intelligence. The advantages of computer intelligence in terms of speed, accuracy, and capacity will be clear. The advantages of human intelligence, on the other hand, will become increasingly difficult to distinguish. The skills of computer software are already better than many people realize. It is frequently my experience that when demonstrating recent advances in, say, speech or character recognition, observers are surprised at the state of the art. For example, a typical computer user's last experience with speech recognition technology may have been a low-end, freely bundled piece of software from several years ago that recognized a limited vocabulary, required pauses between words, and did an incorrect job at that. These users are then surprised to see contemporary systems that can recognize fully continuous speech on a 60,000-word vocabulary with accuracy levels comparable to a human typist. Also, keep in mind that the progression of computer intelligence will sneak up on us. As just one example, consider Garry Kasparov's confidence in 1990 that a computer would never come close to defeating him. After all, he had played the best computers, and their chess-playing ability was pathetic compared to his own. But computer chess playing made steady progress, gaining 45 rating points each year. In 1997, a computer sailed past Kasparov, at least in chess. There has been a great deal of commentary that other human endeavors are far more difficult to emulate than chess playing. This is true. In many areas, the ability to write a book on computers, for example, computers are still pathetic. But as computers continue to gain in capacity.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.